Hello, thank you for joining us today. My name is Robert Vail. I'm Vice President of Sales here at Genea. Today's presentation is Integrating Mobile Access Control with Apple Wallet. For those of you not familiar with Genea, we are a global access control provider based in Southern California. We're currently supporting customers in 27 countries. We have over 3,000 locations and over 1 million users utilizing the product. Supporting large global organizations like Shopify, of course, our friends here at Jamf, iHeartRadio, Sunrun, so great organizations that you know and you've heard of, we're supporting on a global basis. And what makes us unique? One, it's a 100% cloud-based access control solution. We're built on AWS, and what makes that unique is it allows us to really streamline a lot of the processes for adding and removing users, which is, can be very cumbersome when you have large organizations utilizing access control. We want to really make that process streamlined. We are supporting non-proprietary hardware, so we're a Mercury partner. We also support all HID readers, as well as Wavelengths and Steed, to give you a lot of different options as you use different hardware. It also allows us to come in and do a lot of takeovers with existing access control systems that you may already be using. By being cloud-based also allows us to roll out a lot of different things, including mobile access, of course, which we'll talk about shortly, out-of-the-box video integrations with a lot of the cloud-based VMS solutions in the marketplace. We have a native visitor management solution that allows a user to invite a visitor to come on site, go through a pre-registration process, and actually go through and assign a temporary credential to allow those users to come through turnstiles, doors, elevators, anything that they need to. And the other unique thing is we provide 24/7 end user support. So this is direct end user support for anything that is level one software related. And those are by Genea employees 24/7. So within the product and the mobile application, we have live chat. We also have email and of course phone access where you can ask any questions that you need. And for anything that is software related, we're going to manage that for you. For anything that is hardware related, such as controllers going offline, readers failing, things like that, we'll work with our security integrator partners to come on site and do any repairs necessary. But it's a great direct line of communication between us, the end user, as well as your security integrator. And of course, by being cloud-based, allows you to remotely manage physical security from anywhere. So from one login through your web browser here or through your mobile application, I can manage all my sites anytime I want to. And it's very, very simple to do. For mobile access, we want to make it very easy to provision mobile credentials to employees. The way we do this is through all API integrations. So we provide a direct integration with the with either HID Origo database, Steed, or Wavelengths, where it's one-click provisioning to assign a mobile credential. That user is then prompted to either download our application or add their credential to Apple Wallet. Because of the uniqueness of our system, all of our mobile applications are included as part of the subscription, so you're not being charged for every single mobile key that you're going to assign to your employees. And your phone is a much more a secure form of credentialing than a physical card. With your phone, it is single sign-on protected. We can also set up multi-factor authentication where we can require that an employee has to face ID and open their phone before they're allowed to use it on the site, or they can utilize it in the background. It really depends on the security requirements of your organization. But we want to make that very simple to do. And the reason that we're so excited about Apple Wallet is because in traditional mobile applications, they've been used through Bluetooth. And the problem with Bluetooth is it's a slower transaction. You have to open the app. There's a lot of transactions get failed. Bluetooth is very strange, especially if you get to an area where there's turnstiles or there's aluminum siding where the signal bounces around. It can be very challenging to fulfill that transaction. And it actually uses a lot of battery. So the great thing about utilizing Apple Wallet is it really makes this whole process a lot easier and a lot more streamlined. So once again, utilizing our mobile application, it's one-click provisioning where I can add a pass right to my wallet, just like you do with credit card or any or a boarding pass, anything that you're using to. It syncs to our watch. So not only can I use my phone, but I can use my watch and use that NFC credential within my watch. It's very, very fast. So the transaction happens just as fast as a white card. So you take those white cards to any reader and it gets you in the door immediately. It also allows us to do express mode for a very seamless entry. So you don't even have to open up the phone. You can use everything in the background. And it's secure because you've already used your organization's SSO and MFA to log into the app and logged into the phone to enter the facility. And also the battery life is extended beyond. So even if your phone dies, you still have up to 6 hours of life where you can actually use your phone as your credential. So you don't have to worry about getting to a charger and trying to get into the office. As long as you have that phone with you and it's less than 6 hours, you can still use the phone to enter the facility. And if for some reason credentials are lost or you get a new phone, we can quickly reassign a new credential and get you back up and running into the facility very quickly. So obviously we're working with the Jamf organization, supporting all their employees as they go through and utilize Wallet to get into the facilities. That's all managed by Genea. We work with your physical security team in order to help manage the user's credentials, as well as obviously access groups and any type of schedule. So what we're going to do now is a very brief demo on how to utilize the system and show you a couple different unique use cases about the platform. Thank you for joining us today. We're going to do a brief demonstration of the Genea Access Control platform. As you can see, when I first log in, it's a total different look and feel from anything that you may have seen with Access Control. We start with our high-level analytics overview, gives you today's attendance, the busiest hours of the day, how many active users we have at that site. And as I scroll down, I can see our attendance by day and just get a little overview of who's in the site. I can see our busiest doors and the people who are coming in on a daily basis and a high-level heat map. So we just want to give the ability to have some high-level analytics so you can get a quick glance of what's happening at the site. So I'm not going to go through everything related to access control. I'm just going to show you a couple of things that are really unique within our platform. So one of the big things we wanted to make it easy for was reporting and activity of all the employees coming into the system. So when I come on our navigation here, I'm going to go to our activity dashboard. And what we're going to see is all the activity, and this is going to show us from the last 90 days. Our default is to keep history forever within the system, but really what do you need access to is most recent activities. So when I scroll down, I can see, okay, here's Jason coming in. His access was granted in which door? And of course, there's a link to our video management system so I can just see the event happening and see Jason walking through the door. And of course, I can see when that event happened. If I want to filter by anything, I just use our filter here. So say I need to find out anybody who's been denied access to the system or to a door. That quickly, I can come in and see Nicole was denied access, and then we can go through do further investigation as to why that may have happened. I can come, I can clear that event. I can stack multiple events. I can do by users. So say I need to look for Nicole and see all the times that Nicole's been in recently in the last 90 days. I can take this and export it to a CSV file and report in anything else in well. So all data within the system is fully exportable right into a CSV that you can take into any other system that you need. So I'm gonna go ahead and clear that. So that's our activity. So this is our manual activity reporting. I also have the ability to do fully automated reporting where on a daily basis, we can have any type of information that you need to know about the system emailed to anybody in your organization. That can be activity reports, it can be denied events, it can be door held open events, anything that the system can track can be sent into an email and sent to you on a daily, weekly, or even monthly basis. The other thing that we'll go through is our alerting system. So we make it very easy for you to come in and set up alerts for not only connections going down, battery fails, power supply fails. Now I can do this very manual process where I do it through email, or I can use some of the power of our integrations where I can send an alert to a specific Slack channel or a Teams channel to be notified in the event that something is happening at the site and I need to know about it. Our control center is essentially the remote control for the site. I have the ability to come in, I can look at a site, I can even pull up a live camera feed so I can actually see the live stream of the camera, and if I need to, I can do what's called a quick grant and I can let somebody in. So say we had a delivery here at the facility, I see the live camera, I'm gonna come back here to the screen, I'm gonna do a quick grant, and what it did is actually unlock the door for 4 seconds. It's going to go ahead and lock it back up. I can, of course, watch the live video, see that person come through, do delivery, or if, for instance, I need to let somebody in the facility, I can do that all through here, right here in the control center. The control center also allows me to set up a camera wall so I can look at our different feeds. I can organize it, move it around to whatever I need to. Now, there's only 2 cameras here in this facility, but you get the sense of exactly what that means. I have the ability to come and customize any emergency plans for the organization. So if I need to set up rules for this office to actually open doors or trigger an event that pushes people through a certain area, I can do that as well. We have a full access control, scheduling, access groups, holiday groups. We'll support multiple card formats, so it is very easy to set this up as part of the system. I also have the ability to see all of our hardware that may be on site. Now, this is a simple two-door system, so there's not a lot of hardware that's in place. But I can come through, and I can see the status of our hardware. So if I come into our master controller, MAC address, when it was last hosted, what ports it's on, what's it connected to. So it just gives us a nice visual of everything that's going on there. And then the other thing I want to do is to be able to set up users and keys. So this is where we're going to be able to show off the integration between Genea and Apple, to be able to show you how we do that integration with Wallet to provide a mobile credential. So when I come in and I want to add a new employee to the system, all I hit is new. I give them a name, email address, and this is assuming I want to give them a mobile credential. And then I start adding them to offices. I select a role and add them to an access group. Now these access group and the roles are fully customizable once again. So I can give somebody employee access. And if I said, well, okay, not only do you work in Detroit, but you also need to go to our Irvine office. I can add them as an admin to Irvine as well, and give them different permissions, hit save. And now that new user is added to the system. Once I'm in the system, then I'm gonna go ahead and look at the credentials of anybody. So let's just take myself. I can come in and see myself here. Now I can see my general profile. So here's my picture. Here's my profile. I'm a global admin in our system. I can see what department I'm in. I can see if it's synced with our directory service. We have the ability to do fully customized attributes. So because I do have parking in the building, I can come in and I can actually be required to add my license plate number here. And then I can see all the access that I have, all the locations that I have access to. I can globally suspend or activate access to any user to make it a very simple process to do that. So if I find out that somebody's phone has been stolen, their key card's been stolen, they just lost it, I can quickly suspend them, and it doesn't delete them from the system, just temporarily suspends their access. Of course, I can see which buildings they have access to. I can give temporary access. So if I found out that somebody is going to work in Irvine for the week, I can come in, assign them to an access group, and pick an activation date and a deactivation date. So that same credential that you used at the headquarters will also work in your other office, but it'll only work for a week because they've given you temporary access to that facility. So no longer are you trying to track down a facilities manager or an office manager. Hey, let me in. I'm here visiting for the week. You can actually do this here all remotely. Going to send. And then the last part is, of course, adding credentials and keys. So when I come in, I can either add physical cards or mobile keys. So we're going to support both right on our platform. So if you're still using physical key cards, I can come in. I hit key card. I put in the card number. I select the badge type, or I can use our default badge type. The badge types are fully customizable for your organization and, of course, the different roles that you may have in the system. So you may have a badge type for temp workers or a badge type for interns. They can only come in from 9 to 5 during normal business hours. They can't come work after hours. You may have one for janitorial. And then I can go ahead and do a mobile key. So if I want to come into a mobile key, I can hit mobile credential. I can pick my activation date and my deactivation date and hit save. And then what will happen is a new mobile credential will be sent to me that I can go ahead and download and add to my phone or to my wallet. And so now I'm going to show you how easy it is to add a new credential to your wallet. So I'm going to go ahead and share my phone screen. So what you see here on my phone is my wallet. Is my mobile application. So this is the Genea mobile app. So a couple things you can see in here is I have the ability to come and register myself to come on site. I, of course, have the ability as an admin to see all of the users in the site. I can see all the doors, and I can remotely lock or unlock door. And then if I want to take my key and go ahead and add it to my wallet, I just simply hit the Add to Apple Wallet button. It's requesting a pass. So what it's doing is communicating via API right back from our platform to the, in this case, the HID Origo platform. And it's going to populate a pass and go ahead and send that to me. Now here's my pass. I hit add. So I'm adding it to a wallet just like you normally would do with your boarding passes, your credit cards, or anything that you may do. Tickets to sporting events are all going to be added right into your pass. And as long as you have your Apple ID logged into the system, it'll be very simple for you to go do that. And then from there, I can use this not only here on my phone, but on my Apple Watch. So it's done. I've got an Express Pass. It's in my wallet now. and here's my Genea key. So now I can use my phone or the NFC chip that is actually on my wallet. I can enter any facility and it is a lightning fast experience. So that is how quickly we can go ahead and add Apple Wallet, and the experience is an incredible one. So thank you much for your time. And how we get the wallets, to get the credentials in wallet, it's very simple. You just log into the Genea Access Control system that your facility set up. You go through, you work with your account manager, you get your Apple Business Registry. So there's a process that we'll go through with you and the Apple team to have that set up. And then we deploy it. It can happen very quickly and then really easily as a way to have, of course, all your employees utilizing Apple Wallet as a way to enter the facilities. Thank you very much for your time.